Central Research Laboratory was established in October 2014 with financial support given by the University Grant Commission and Government of Bihar. The idea being that the high-priced instruments, which may not be available to young budding scientists and researchers in individual laboratories, can be made available at Central Research Laboratory. Let's begin our virtual tour to Central Research Laboratory.
Medical reagents, biological samples at the temperature of minus 20 degrees Celsius.
This equipment is hematoanalyzer and it is used for complete blood count, which includes RBC count, WBC count, hemoglobin level, hematocritic level and platelets.
This is a fluorescence microscope. It works on the principle of fluorescence as it absorbs the shorter wavelength radiations and emits the longer wavelength radiations. This equipment is used to study the morphology of bacteria.
This instrument is called as conductivity meter. A conductivity meter is a device that is used to measure electrical current or conductance in a solution. The rods using the conductivity meter is made up of platinum. Right now, I'm measuring the conductivity of the sample.
This is a bacterial incubator and it is a device which we use to grow and maintain a biological culture inside. Now I am going to keep this culture inside the incubator at 37 degrees centigrade.
This is a gradient PCR. It differs from the conventional PCR. It optimizes the PCR reaction by determining the exact annealing temperature.
This equipment is laminar airflow and it is used for creating contamination work-free environment through installed HEPA filters. And it is also used for transferring bacterial cultures under aseptic conditions.
Analyzer reader is used to measure and quantitate the color difference in the 12 well of the plate. It also do photospectrometry, which emits light of only one wavelength. It is an instrument which is used to test all the biological factors related to antibody-antigen reactions like HIV, RIA, typhoid and ELISA.
So this is a gel documentation system or gel imager system. This is widely used for documentation and imaging of nucleic acid and proteins suspended within polyacrylamide or agglutinins.
This equipment is FTIR spectrophotometer. FTIR stands for Fourier Transform Infrared Spectrophotometer. In FTIR spectroscopy, IR is passed through a sample. Some of the IR is absorbed by the sample and some of it passed through. This equipment is used for the identification of unknown materials.
This equipment is rotatory evaporator. It is used for efficient and gentle removal of solvents from samples by evaporation. It is also used for extracting secondary metabolite from plants. Right now, I am extracting curcumin from Curcuma longa.
Grinding ball mill is a device that is used to break solid materials into fine particles by cutting, crushing or grinding. Grinding occurs through mechanical force.
The instrument is HPLC or High Performance Liquid Chromatography. It's an analytical instrument used to separate, identify and quantify any component in a given sample.
Ultrasonicator is a machine widely used in the laboratory. It is the act of applying sonicator energy to extract multiple compounds from plants, seaweeds and microalgae. Right now I am testing this sample via ultrasonicator.
This is a high-speed centrifuge. It uses centrifugal force to separate various components of fluid. It ranges from 5,000 to 30,000 rotations per minute. Right now I am using this sample to isolate DNA.
This machine is double beam spectrophotometer which utilizes two light beams, one which passes through the sample and another which passes through the reference part.
This equipment is called incubator shaker. We use it to maintain liquid medium cultures.
Atomic absorption spectroscopy is a spectroanalytical procedure for the quantitative determination of a chemical elements using the absorption of a optical radiation by free atoms in the gaseous state. atomic absorption spectroscopy is based on the absorption of light from free metallic ion. It is used to estimate the heavy metals from any unknown sample. Right now, I am estimating chromium level from the sample.
The stereo zoom microscope is an optical microscope variant designed for the low magnification observation of a sample, typically using light reflected from the surface of an object rather than transmitted through. It is used to observe fungal spore directly from petri plate.
And this video is a very brief run through of our botany department laboratory in Patna Women's College, just to give you an idea of what a general setup and stuff and feel in a lab maybe kind of look like. So let's go.
This is salicylate extraction unit. We are extracting fat from capsicum. In the round bottom flask, we have a solvent, petroleum ether as solvent. And in the siphon tube, we have taken thimble in which we have put our sample, and above it is a condenser.
They are using biofuels and extraction of oils from various materials, and they are using environmental analysis of soil, sludge and waste.
An instrument known as water bath. It is based on the principle of incubation of sample in a water at a constant temperature for a long period of time. It is used for melting media.
It is made up of a stainless steel body. The interface given here is to set the temperature, and it is made on a point. And we use it to melt our media, to put culture mediums and the chemicals which can cause direct inflammations. We need it here in the water bath.
This is a single beam digital spectrophotometer. It tells us the absorbance of light by a sample solution. For measuring the sample solution, you place a blank in the cuvette holder. It works on the principle of Beer-Lambert's law, by which we establish a linear co-relationship between concentration and absorbance of a sample solution. The uses are for quantitative and qualitative estimation of DNA and RNA and proteins, and for checking the purity of a sample solution.
This is a laminar airflow instrument, and it works on the principle of HEPA filter, that is high efficiency particulate air, and it's mainly used to prevent from contamination of microorganisms. Here, she is demonstrating the spreading of bacterial culture media by serial dilution method.
So, autoclave, it works on the principle of sterilization. It is used for 15 minutes at 121 degrees C and 15 LPS pressure. It is for the body to replace microorganisms.
It is an instrument known as a botic setter. It is used for thermal laboratory and mixing of sample vials of liquid. It consists of tubes and micro tubes 30 mm in diameter, and it is also used for homogenization and cell disruption.
This is a device called pH meter. The full form of pH is put by potential of hydrolysis, power of hydrolysis, or potential of hydrolysis. It is used to measure the acidity or the basicity of the aqueous solution. Here we have the aqueous solution in, and we measure the reading. The reading is showing here for the pH of this. It shows 8.75 pH of this water.
This is a shaker incubator. The shaker incubator is a thermostatically controlled apparatus which is used to cultivate the microorganisms in a broth medium.
It works by providing evenly distributing nutrients throughout the sample. It also provides consistent temperature to the sample.
This is a double beam spectrophotometer. It is used for measuring the absorbance of light of a specific solution. The solutions are placed in the quartz cuvette, and the cuvette is placed in the quartz chamber. We can measure the absorbance and concentration of a solution at single wavelength as well as multi-wavelength in this double scan, double beam spectrophotometer.
This here is laboratory centrifuge. Centrifugation is a technique by which we separate solid suspended into liquid or liquid-liquid separation based on the mass and density by means of high-speed rotation. It is based on the principle of sedimentation, that is, the heavier particles settle down and the lighter particle lifts up.
Okay, this is the centrifugation chamber. We have a rotator over here which has a motor fixed as its base. These are the vials in which we place the solutions we want to centrifuge, and then we close the lid. After that, from here we set the timer, and from here we set the speed and switch on the power and the device.
Convection. It has electrically heated chamber and preset gas concentration that is used to maintain the optimum temperature for the normal growth of the cell. And it has a thermostat that is used to set the desired temperature. And when that particular temperature is reached to that point, the connection is automatically cut off.
Departmental Lab of Zoology. It was established in the year 1988. Research projects under DBT, CP and BSR have been carried over here. Students have researched on the topic histopathology and toxicology over here. This lab allows to put the creativity and interest of the students at a practical level.
This equipment is known as laminar airflow. It is used to sterilize the contaminated air in an enclosed area. Right now, I am transferring the Streptococcus pneumonia bacteria from the nutrient compartment in front of the Bunsen burner to avoid contamination.
A centrifuge is a device that works on centrifugal force. It works by moving the fluid at a very high speed within the container. Over here, we are extracting DNA from the sheep liver.
This equipment is called Automated Clinical Chemistry Analyzer, and this works on the principle of determining the concentration of metabolite, electrolyte, protein or any other drug in our blood, lymph, urine or any body fluid. And right now I am analyzing the urine analysis to see the concentration of fluoride. Digital conductivity meter. This works on the principle of photometric method. Right now I am measuring the conductivity of our tap water of our laboratory.
Digital pH meter. It mainly works on a principle to determine the acidity or the basicity of the solution. It mainly consists of a probe which is made up of a glass connected to an electric meter which displays the pH value of a solution. This device is already calibrated at pH 9 and pH 4.
Hot plate equipment. This equipment is used for heating the solution or medium for biochemical testing. Right now, I am putting this sample for estimating calcium in milk.
It works at 121 degrees Celsius and 15 LBS pressure for 15 minutes. It is used mainly for the sterilization of different equipment, glassware, plastic vase and media.
Deep freezer. It is an equipment that maintains temperature ranging from minus 20 degrees Celsius to minus 80 degrees Celsius. It is used to preserve various types of chemicals and biological samples for a longer period of time.
Hello and welcome to the Department of Microbiology, Patna Women's College. Here in our laboratory, we practice basic microbiological techniques like sterilization, preparation of different microbiological media, isolation of bacteria, inoculation, incubation, and identification of different microorganisms through various biochemical tests. So let's begin our tour.
This is a minus 20 degrees Celsius refrigerator, and this refrigerator plays a very important role in safe storage of vaccines, reagents, and microbial cells. This is of huge importance in clinical, pharmaceutical, and microbiological laboratories.
This is a spectrophotometer. It is used to measure the amount of light absorbed by the sample, and it is based on Beer and Lambert's law. It is used to take the OD of the cells, that is optical density of the cells.
And this is a cuvette in which we'll pour our sample to 3/4 volume. And this cuvette will be placed in the blanks provided here. And this is a light source from where the light will come and pass through the sample. And we'll have to close it and we'll set the wavelength and also the time for which we want to take the OD.
This is an autoclave. Bacteria, viruses, and
agarose gel electrophoresis unit. It is used to separate DNA on the basis of its molecular weight in a matrix of agarose. This is the casting gel tray where we cast the gel, and this is the UV transilluminator where we visualize the DNA fragments as with the help of TBR.
RZ's microscope with camera in which a photographic film is inserted through which we can develop an image of microorganism which can be visualized later as it is shown here.
This is a special apparatus where we culture anaerobic bacteria. For culturing aerobic bacteria, we have normal incubator, but for culturing anaerobic bacteria, we have this special setup where we can adjust the condition where oxygen is not supplied.
This is a cooling centrifuge and it works on the principle of sedimentation. Substances with higher density, they settle at the bottom of any solution when we place them. And these are two tubes which I am going to place. I am going to place together. And they will be placed at same distance facing each other so that they maintain equilibrium.
This is Colony counter. Colony counter is an instrument that count bacteria or other microorganism which grown on an agar plate.
This is a shaker incubator. It is used to blend, mix or agitate substances in a flask or tubes by shaking them. It is useful for microbial growth as it provides optimal temperature and RPM while shaking substances to provide nutrients and oxygen for even distribution in the culture.
This device is known as incubator. It is based on the principle of thermoelectricity. The incubator has thermostat which maintains the optimal temperature of incubator by creating thermal gradient.
Welcome to the Department of Physics at Patna Women's College. I am Meenal and it gives me immense pleasure to introduce you to our department and show you our laboratory facilities. Our department houses a total of 5 laboratories dedicated for undergraduate and postgraduate education. These labs are namely the Undergraduates Lab, Optics Lab, Electronics Lab, Mechanics Lab and Research Lab. So, without any further ado, let's start the virtual tour of our department right from the Mechanics Lab.
Welcome to the Mechanics Lab. Here we start with a basic pendulum called a bar pendulum. Here, bar pendulum is a metallic bar in which the holes are drilled in such a way that the lines of this holes can pass through the center of gravity of a bar pendulum. We use this apparatus to find the value of acceleration due to gravity.
This is torsional pendulum. We use this to find out the modulus of rigidity of this thin wire. This wire is fixed at one end and at the other end a cylinder is attached. We give a small oscillation to this cylinder, calculate the time period of this oscillation and we find out the ratio of length of this wire and square of time period of the oscillation and substitute the value and find out the modulus of rigidity of this thin wire.
Kitter pendulum is a composed of a metal rod upon which mounted two metal equipment like this and this and two wooden sliding cylinders, this and there are two knob lengths which face on each other and this is a simple pendulum. We use this Kettle's pendulum because it measures the acceleration due to gravity value with a greater accuracy than any other simple pendulum.
Here I am to introduce you to sonometer. This interesting setup is sonometer. It mainly has two objectives. First, it gives the relation between the frequency and the length of the wire at constant tension. Second, it gives the relation between the tension and the length of the wire at constant frequency. It also helps to develop the idea about standing waves.
The apparatus by my side is called Barton's apparatus. It is used to measure the modulus of rigidity of any given material. This apparatus uses some weights that put strain on the wire. On paper, we know that modulus of rigidity is obtained by the ratio of shear stress and shear strain. But here in the static method, we use Barton's apparatus that comes up with a twist in the wire, which are measured by these two leading gauges upon adding some weight on these scales. And hence, we get the modulus of rigidity.
This setup is Hall effect measurement setup. This is the power supply which is connected to the electromagnet. It has two stands. One has a germanium NP type semiconductor. This is connected to the Hall effect setup. This measures the current and the voltage. This stand is connected to the Gauss meter, which will measure the magnetic field. The whole motive of this apparatus is to measure the voltage difference across an electrical semiconductor or conductor, transfers through the electric current in the conductor and applied magnetic field and perpendicular to the current.
This apparatus is of NPN transistor. NPN transistor consists of two N-type and one P-type semiconductors sandwiched together. This device is basically used to obtain the graph of characteristic curves of input and output current and voltage respectively. And the characteristic curve gives the relationship between current and voltage that is theoretically well established.
This apparatus is commonly called as CRO and its full form is cathode ray oscilloscope. This apparatus has a very wide range of applications in almost every field. In hospitals, this apparatus is used to note the reactions of our nervous system and heartbeat. In radio stations, this apparatus is used for transmitting signals and receiving signals and to get the graph between AM and FM. Here in our department, we use this apparatus to get the curves such as transistor curves and BH curve under hysteresis loop.
This is an apparatus for Zener diode. Zener diode is heavily doped PN junction which acts as a voltage regulator. It works in reverse bias. When we change the voltage, the current changes. At a certain voltage, the current rises suddenly. This is the breakdown voltage. And this is the most important characteristics of Zener diode.
This is the setup for field effect transistor. Field effect transistor is a type of transistor that uses electric field to control the flow of current. In this setup, there are three terminals, gate, drain and source. The voltage between drain and source controls the flow of current throughout.
This is the setup which we use to calculate the wavelength of a monochromatic light with the use of Newton's ring. To form Newton's ring, we use this moving telescope and we calculate the diameter of the ring. To calculate the diameter of the ring, we use this main scale and a circular scale. Move this left and an equivalent right and we calculate the diameter of the ring.
Chemistry. I am Trishna Singh and it gives me an immense pleasure to welcome you all to the virtual tour of our departmental laboratory. Our department has two laboratories for the UG students and one research lab which is equipped with various technical instruments such as flame photometer, spectrophotometer, soil and water kit, etc. So without any delay, let's begin our virtual tour.
This device is called UV visible spectrophotometer. It measures the intensity of light when it passes through a sample and compares it to the intensity of light when it passes through a blank sample. It is very useful in analytical chemistry. It basically measures and it detects the transient metal ions and conjugated organic molecules. The samples are basically loaded in a qubit and the qubit can be of two types. Either it can be made up of quartz or it can be made up of glass. Quartz is basically used when UV light is passed and glass is used when visible light is passed.
This kit is known as water and soil analysis kit. It is used to test the purity of drinking water and wastewater quality. It is a unique portable instrument for measurement of various parameters of water like pH, conductivity, TDS, dissolved oxygen, temperature and ampere of many solutions. It has a chargeable battery inside the kit that makes it extremely useful for field and laboratory uses.
This is gas chromatography. It is based on the principle that when the sample inserted in the instrument, it enters the gas stream which transports the solution into a separation tube known as column. The various components are separated inside a column. The typical use of gas chromatography include testing the purity of a substance or separating the various components of a mixture.
This device is called bomb calorimeter. It is used to measure the cross calorific value of a solid and liquid samples. It is a constant volume type calorimeter that can use to measure a heat of a particular reaction or calorific value of the fuel. Right now I am going to check the calorific value of this food sample through this bomb calorimeter.
So
this device is microprocessor calorimeter. The working principle of a calorimeter is based upon Beer-Lambert's law, which states that the amount of light passed through a colored solution is directly proportional to the concentration of the solution and the length of light path through the solution. So this device detects the color of a solution and it is used to determine the concentration of a solution.
This is a digital conductivity meter. It measures the electrical conductivity of a solution. This is a multiple application in which with common uses aquaculture hydroponics freshwater system to monitor the amount of nutrients, salts and impure water.
This device is known as flame photometer. It is used to determine the concentration of certain metals such as lithium, potassium, calcium and sodium. It is based on the principle on the measurement of emitted light intensity when the metal is exposed to flame.
This instrument, pH meter, was discovered by Arnoldo Bergman. It basically measures the hydrogen ion activity in a solution. Basically, it measures the acidity or basicity of a solution digitally.
Developed a web page on campus recruitment training. This is our home page and about us courses, login and register are linked together. This is our home page.
3D printer, and in this printer, sir, we are using a mask holder which we are printing here using this 3D printer. And sir, the user will hold this mask holder and will always carry a mask with it. We'll also apply a key ring with this mask holder, and we have used this device. Also, we have printed this device using this 3D printer.
This is a C++ program. I am doing this on Turbo C++ platform. It will print the even numbers from 2 to 100.